What's up, guys? It's TechnoViking23 coming to you today with a bit of an update video. Just wanted to kind of catch up, let you know how I'm doing, let you know what I'm doing with the channel, and just kind of ramble on a little bit. It's been a while since I've been able to do one of these, so that's kind of why it's just time to sort of do one and let you guys know what's going on. I've still been really busy with work, and I'm still working two jobs, which is taking up a lot of time. I sit in traffic quite a bit every week as well. I've really enjoyed getting back down to Atlanta, but one of the worst things about living here is the traffic is absolutely insane. I actually sat down the other day and wrote down on a piece of paper how many hours I spend in traffic every week, and it's some ridiculous number. It's like 3 hours a day, and I only live 20 miles from my office. So 40-mile round trip every day, I spend about 3 hours in traffic. I could actually probably drive to Charlotte from here or drive somewhere pretty far away in that amount of time that I spend every day. But it's pretty crazy. It's pretty insane. But the problem is there's really no easy solution for it. Here, the public transit's not very great up where I live, so that wouldn't really help. The roads, they're trying to widen the roads to get to accommodate the volume of people, because Atlanta actually is a very quickly growing city, which is surprising, because when I left it several years ago, they'd just gone through a really big real estate crash and things weren't looking so good. But now the city's back. They're really developing a lot of things commercially, and it seems like everything's been revitalized, and a lot of growth going on. A lot of people are moving here. A lot of people are in the northern suburbs, and it just makes it kind of crazy every day trying to get to work. But hopefully school is going to be out pretty soon, and then we'll be able to have a little bit of relief from that. It's amazing how much of the traffic in the morning is actually from parents driving their kids to school every day. So, you know, I remember the day when I was at school and everybody rode the bus or we walked to school. You know, we didn't really worry about having to have our parents drop us off the doorstep. But, you know, times are changing. That's definitely clear. But that's something for another time. I'm not going to get into that here. But otherwise, things are going pretty good. Work is great. I love my new job that I got down here. I'm still doing a lot of title work, which is what I was doing up north, but I'm doing it in a different setting. And I'm also in an office now, so the employment is steady and permanent, and I don't have to worry about being independent anymore. While I really did enjoy doing that for 5 years and kind of being my own boss and having time to do whatever I wanted to do and, you know, being able to take time off whenever I wanted, there was always the uncertainty of the work running out or something happening. And that's what, you know, happened last year, midway through the year, and I was unemployed for most of 2015, which really sucked. It wasn't a lot of fun, but it kind of allowed me to start my YouTube channel and start working on that. So in a way, that was kind of cool, but, you know, not having work was not good. Not knowing when I was going to get my next paycheck or be able to buy groceries really sucked. So I'm really enjoying having the stability now in my life. It takes up a lot of time, like I said. That's one of the drawbacks, but I'll take it for right now, considering how bad last year was. It doesn't give me as much time to work on YouTube stuff, but I still try to put out a couple videos a week just to keep you guys entertained. That's pretty much it. That's pretty much what's going on. I've kind of cut my hours down at my retail job so that I'm not working nearly as much. I'm trying to take request some more days off there so that I'm, you know, have at least one or two days off every 2 or 3 weeks. Because as it's been going pretty much since I moved down here, I work about usually 20 to 25 days between days off, and that can really get grinding on you. But I'm also going to the gym quite a bit. One of the cool things about my job is I work with a lot of people who are fitness oriented and really passionate about doing sports and things outside of work. And one of the ladies I work with is actually an aerobics instructor at one of the local gyms, and she's a nutritionist and all this, and she's really helped me kind of get my diet in order. And I've actually lost about 17 pounds since I moved down here. I've been going to the gym, you know, 4 to 5 days a week, and just doing a lot of cardio and lifting again. When I moved down here, I was 265 pounds, and I'm down to 248. I'm trying to get down eventually to between 225 and 235, which was my really good weight right out of college when I was in really, really good shape. And trying to get back to that point, maybe start running some 5Ks again and getting back into mountain biking and things. Just so it's been really nice, you know, living down here. There's a lot of outdoor stuff going on. People are very active, and it's kind of a more positive environment to be consistent and stick with going to the gym. And I have that reinforcement at work every day, and it's really led to a lot of cool life changes for me, especially, you know, dieting. I used to eat fast food probably 3 or 4 times a week, especially when I was always on the road being self-employed, you know, having to drive all over the place for work. You know, it was very difficult to make lunch every day. And of course, I'm one of those people. I'll admit it. I'm kind of lazy in the morning. When I get up out of bed, it's like I pretty much roll out of bed, brush my teeth, get dressed, get a bagel and a coffee, and go to work. You know, I'm not one of those people who wants to get up and have to make lunch and sit there and eat a huge breakfast and and cook and do all this other stuff. So I've been actually slowly trying to change that, and I'm starting to get up a little bit earlier in the morning and, you know, take lunch to work and eat a little bit healthier. I started eating a lot of fruit. You know, I only eat fast food now, if anything, maybe once a week. And it's actually funny because it's more enjoyable not having it as much when you actually do have it. So eating a lot better, that's helped me lose a lot of weight as well, in addition to the working out. So that's been really the only personal stuff going on. Like I said, work has pretty much just taken up a lot of my time. And we've also had some problems with the cat. And I brought her down from Pennsylvania, and I don't know if it's just southern allergies and different things, but she's been having some problems with her ears. It's just not ear mites, it's some kind of earwax or infection. We're not quite sure what it is, but we've been kind of dealing with it for the past couple of months, and the vet doesn't seem to know what's going on. We've taken her to the vet 4 or 5 times, and he just doesn't have any idea. And we've tried a different vet, and you know, I know veterinarians work very hard, and it's hard to diagnose problems with animals, but at this point it almost seems a little bit like a scam. Like, you know, just bring her back in 2 weeks and spend another $100 and we'll tell you the same crap again, that we just don't know what's going on. So fortunately we found some other remedies just by searching online and asking around, and she seems to be doing better. We're using some natural stuff to treat her ear infection, and she's actually getting really good now, so it seems like we may be at the end of the rope on that and might be getting out of the woods finally, getting her adjusted down here to the south, because I know the pollen down here is different, everything's a little bit different, so probably just her trying to get used to what's going on down here. But other than that, everything is going pretty well for me, I have to say. A lot better than it was a couple months ago when I first moved down here and things weren't looking so great with work and not having a job, but that's going really, really well, and I'm very thankful for all that. Anyways, on to gaming and kind of the channel. We're playing a little Warframe here. That's kind of what's occupying my time of late, is Warframe. I don't know what's happened with this game, but I've just completely fallen in love with Warframe again. I used to play this back on the PC when it was in the early, early beta stages, and kind of had a love-hate relationship with it. I'd play it for a couple months, then quit for a while, then play it for a couple months, and quit for a while. Just never really could get into it. And I came back finally, you know, last year and started playing again, as you guys know through my videos, and they've just completely changed a lot of things with the game. The developers seem to really put a lot of money back into it. They seem to add a lot of things a lot of time. I know there's a lot of drama also going on within the Warframe community right now, some stuff with the developers supporting certain sides of that, and I don't think that's cool, but I'm not going to get into that. That's not the purpose of this video or my channel really even. But, you know, overall to me it seems like they do a decent job of, you know, putting money people spend on the microtransactions back into the game. They seem to add some really good content often. There's often very large updates to Warframe, free updates, and the game is completely free to play. I've got about, I think, 70 hours into it now on my account on PlayStation 4, and I've just got a ton of stuff, and I really haven't spent a dime on this game, and it's really cool to be able to actually go through and earn stuff. And reminds me of the old MMOs I used to play all the time, where, yeah, there's this very intense grind. It can be intensive, but at the end of the day, you get something for that grind. You have an item in mind you're going for, or something you're trying to build or get parts for, and at the end of the day, you wind up getting that, and it's very rewarding and satisfying to have that feeling at the end of the day that you actually worked for it and got something. So really enjoying Warframe. Probably going to keep on playing and covering that. I'm going through some videos now, making some stuff to try to help people who are first starting the game. I myself am just kind of in the mid-game. I'm unlocking all the later planets right now and getting into the void. I've been soloing some tier 3 void stuff. And it's funny because I know a lot about the beginning opening stages of the game, what to do, but I'm still learning a lot about some of the more advanced stuff in the game and the more advanced Warframe. So as I go through that process, I'm definitely going to share that with you guys. And I've started a Let's Play, actually, which I've already put the first episode up. I'll be uploading some more episodes where I'm going through the initial stages of the game just so you guys can see me actually playing it and talking about what's going on and what I'm doing. And then I'm also, of course, supplement that with the individual videos that I'm posting up. So I'm going to have a lot of Warframe stuff coming. I feel like I'm sort of neglecting Mass Effect 3 multiplayer a little bit, which Warframe is similar to in the fact that it's third person and it's co-op and it's very fun. But it's just taking up all my time right now. I am going to get back into Mass Effect and actually get some more videos of that going up, because I do really, really love Mass Effect, and it's kind of funny Warframe's pulling me away from it a little bit. But I do want to do some more videos about Andromeda, as well as BioWare's having some issues. It seems like keeping employees, so I want to talk about that a little bit. It's a video I'll probably put up in a week or two. Got some more Halo 5 stuff coming, but I've really kind of just not even been playing Halo 5. You know, I really enjoyed the multiplayer when I first came back to it, but after I picked Warframe up again, I just haven't had any reason to play Halo. It's just, I don't know. I'm glad I only spent $30 on it, but, you know, I had a bunch of videos planned. I was going to review The Division, but, you know, I just got, didn't even feel like it after I started playing Warframe again. And I wanted to talk about Doom a little bit. I did play the Doom beta, and I gotta say, I don't know what it was, but I just wasn't impressed. You know, it just felt, the pacing and everything, I didn't like how quick the multiplayer was. The time to kill seemed really fast, and I remember playing the old arena shooters back in the day on PC, and it just didn't, just didn't vibe well with me for some reason. It seemed like, especially given that some players had been playing it a lot longer in the beta, and they had better items and things, and it's just for a newer player starting off, you can get ganked pretty bad when you first start, but as you unlock stuff, you get a little bit better, but I just overall didn't like the feeling of the multiplayer. Just it didn't really appeal to me at all, and I think I'm just burned out on first-person shooters. I just think, you know, a lot of people have mentioned, well, you should try Overwatch or Battleborn, or neither one of those games appeal to me at all. I think I'm just so burned out on the FPS genre right now. It seems very stagnant. Maybe those games are fun for some people, but I see absolutely no attraction or no reason to play any of those. So I'm sticking with Warframe for right now. Like I said, I'll still do some occasional Mass Effect stuff and maybe talk about Halo here and there. I have a couple Halo speculation videos coming out for Halo 6. Now, I have pretty much quit even talking about Destiny at this point because really there's not much to talk about. I did that one video about how it's a cheap cash grab, and that was even made more obvious by this recent update with these sterling treasure boxes and, you know, trying to entice people to pay real money for this, and seeing the amount of people that actually have paid real money for that. It just shows me the direction Destiny is going and is never going to change. And it's really, it's disheartening, and at the point, you know, you really just don't even want to talk about it anymore. You know, because there's really nothing you can do, because all of the big channels who promote Destiny and support Bungie, you're never going to be able to get a word in edgewise. And those people are already brainwashed. They've got their hundreds of thousands of subscribers who are never going to change their opinion of the game, which is fine. You know, if they enjoy it, great, whatever. I'm at the point now where I'm going to do what's fun for me. And I'm having fun playing Warframe, so I'm gonna concentrate on that. If Bungie, you know, does anything really stupid, I'll probably still mention it. But there's really just been nothing to talk about with it, so it's one of the reasons I've pretty much quit even doing videos about any of the issues with it, because there's really no point anymore. And you know, like I said, with not having as much time anymore, I have to kind of be selective with what I'm making in terms of videos. So I'm gonna focus on what I'm enjoying, which is playing Warframe and Mass Effect. You know, this year and last year have really just been kind of a drought for games. You know, that's something, a problem I think we've had since, really for me, since 2012. There really haven't been a lot of games that have come out that I've looked forward to or wanted to actually buy or play. And I'm really getting tired of this whole multiplayer-only direction a lot of games seem to be going in. You know, I'm really, it's one of the reasons I'm still playing a little bit of Dragon Age Inquisition and still playing Mass Effect, because I just love that single-player story aspect of games that I really wish some companies, some of the bigger companies, would go back to focusing on that. You know, I was so disappointed to play Halo 5 again and see just how bad the story was and how the focus was, again, mostly on multiplayer. And it seems that just is the direction we're going now, to appease the masses and appease the young kids and people with low attention spans, you know, who can't handle a complicated, complex, well-done story. So that's one of the reasons I'm hoping Mass Effect Andromeda will deliver, although I'm a little concerned about that, and I'll be talking about that later. But, yeah, I'm not a huge fan of the way gaming is going nowadays. You know, it just seems like they're not really making games anymore for people like me who like the narrative and the story-driven content in the game. So we'll see if that continues in 2016. But right now, there's really no games on my radar. Andromeda was a big one, but it's probably not going to come out till 2017 now, and I'll talk about that in a video I'm going to make for that later on. No Man's Sky is one game I am keeping an eye on. That does come out next month in June, so we don't have much longer to wait on that. I really like what I'm seeing from Hello Games. It's a game that I've been really hyped about since it first came out. The exploration aspect of it is really cool. I really like that. But as I see more and more gameplay about it, I'm getting a little concerned, because personally, I look at it and I don't know if there's going to be any narrative story elements or anything. It doesn't seem like it. And I know I'm going to get bored fast of just going around collecting items on planets and building ships and things. It's just, I don't see it as a game. I don't know if it's going to be able to sustain my attention span for a long period of time if it doesn't have any deep lore and type of narrative stuff that you can discover in game. So it's one of those games I look at and I'm like, yeah, I could buy the game, might enjoy it, but after maybe 20 or 30 hours, am I just going to get completely bored of it, you know? So I'll be paying attention to that, and we'll see what happens. I may just pick it up anyways, because I'm really excited to see what they do with the game and if they deliver on the promises, but I haven't pre-ordered it. I don't pre-order games anymore. It's one of the dumbest things you honestly can really do as a gamer, is give companies your money before you ever see a finished product. And as the direction gaming is going in nowadays, definitely there's no point in pre-ordering, because a lot of these AAA companies especially are just they're just doing it wrong. You know, they're trying to go the way of mobile games and put in very simplified content, microtransactions and whatnot. They're not really concentrating on making an enjoyable experience for people. It's just let's see who we can appeal to the masses, who want things done right now, who are willing to pay to get things a little bit faster. And that's what happens. And I know people are gonna be like, well, we're playing Warframe and that's got microtransactions. Yeah, it does, and I can see that point. But at the same time, the microtransactions in Warframe are there if you sort of want to speed up the acquisition of getting certain items in the game. You can spend money and buy a Warframe, but that Warframe still starts off at level zero. You still have to level that Warframe up. You still have to learn how to play that Warframe. And you can buy the best Warframe in the game and still suck complete balls at it because you don't know how to play it. You don't know the play style. You know, the game has a very significant learning curve when it comes to playing each frame and each weapon type. So yeah, even though you can buy those weapons and things if you want and skip the grind on them, you still got to invest the time, learn how to use them, learn how to play the frame and things like that. So I don't see it much as a problem in Warframe. And the other thing too is in Warframe you can tell that the developers, they put the money back into the game. That's evident on the updates. I mean, Warframe does a free update and it's like 5 gigs worth of content. You know, Bungie does a free update for Destiny and it's like, what, 1.4 megabytes and it's just a bunch of reskin crap and garbage that they already had in the game that you just trick you with, you know. Whereas in Warframe, they actually do add new weapons, new Warframes, new map skins. You know, they change things up a bit. They put in new quests. They actually put the effort back into the game, which is why I support the developer in terms of playing the game and giving them some good prizes. They haven't really shown me any reason to doubt them so far. That's kind of my little ramble there. Anyways, guys, I've rambled on long enough, but I just wanted to give you guys an update. So for the channel, you're probably going to be seeing a lot of Warframe stuff recently and lately. Even though it doesn't get a whole lot of comments or attention, I really don't care about that. You know, if I wanted to get a lot of comments and subscribers and attention, I'd just make Destiny package opening videos, because that's what everybody's doing nowadays. But I just want to start enjoying, you know, making content I'm having fun with, and, you know, I don't care who watches it or whatnot. I'm not about the view numbers or sub numbers. You know, I just like to have fun and talk about gaming and share it with you guys. So really grateful that you guys tune in, and everybody who comments and offers, you know, advice and criticism and things on the channel. It's great. It's been great having this little community here and building my channel up over time. It's been a lot of fun. So anyways, guys, it's going to do it. I'll try not to go so long between update videos next time. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you guys have any comments or questions, feel free to leave them down below. I hope you guys are having a great day. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you again next time.